boundary that sin created. Bwana asifiwe. Amekata hiyo mpaka enye dhambi iliweka kati yetu na Mungu. Yesu ametuunganisha na Mungu. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. God is good. Yesu ametuunganisha na Mungu. I will go back to 2 Corinthians 5:17. But I want you to see something here. I want you to see something here. If it is true, I want to tell you guys, if it is true, are we okay? Econa issues. It's okay, no problem. Renox, you can try and cook something here. Listen, if it is true that we were truly cut off from God, yeah? Let me begin from here. Tuliumbwa na Mungu, si ndio? Tuliumbwa na Mungu. Tumekubali tumeumbwa na Mungu, sisi ni watu ambao hawajajitengenezea mili yao na roho yao. We are God's creatures. Now, everybody knows binadamu akizaliwa anakuanga amekuwa programmed the wrong way. Eh? Unazaliwa kama uko off. Hao watoto ni wasumbufu sana. Tendio? Yeah. Oh, is it something, are they naturally nice? Are they naturally nice? No. I think Pasi explained it very well to us. Watoto wanajipenda sana. Wakiamuka usiku hawatai kujua kama nyinyi mumelala saa ngapi ni kupiga nduru. Yeah? They come out of the womb, they begin crying. Yeah? Kids are not evil people. They have not even had time to be evil. Sindio? Awajakuwa na opportunity ya kuwa wabaya. Sindio? But interestingly, we all agree that there's naturally something wrong. It is a thief and it was just born the other day. Sindio? It steals, it lies, it does something wrong to other kids. Yeah? And these are small babies. We know that there is something wrong. We have evidence of sin in babies. There is no doubt that naturally human beings are born on the wrong side. Okay? Others are better than others, but who wants to be the best sinner that went to hell? Somebody said. Yeah? Yeah. So we know naturally binadamu wako na amezaliwa akiwa na off key. But we know God is good. The Bible says God is light. Can we look at that? 1 John chapter 1 verse 5. He says God is light and inside God there is no darkness. At all. Praise the Lord. When Jesus came on this world, he said, as long as I'm in the world, what did he say? I am the light of the world. As long as, he says, I'm the light of the world. He was talking about another time when other lights will come. Praise the Lord. And we are here, we thank God. But I want you to see something. If we know God is not the source of evil from the word of God, if we know God is not the one killing people, if we know God is not behind terrorists, do you know what the worst thing is? Those people who tell us that God is the one responsible for terror attacks, if you ask them to do what they are accusing God of, they will not do it. They will tell you, "Hey, nimbaya kufanya mtu. You are nicer than God." That is what you are saying. You are better than God. God is killing people and ni wacha mapenzi yako ifanye. Hakuna kitu kama hiyo. We know from the Bible, God is good. God is good. If you don't agree with this, then stop saying, if you claim to agree with the truth, that God is good, stop saying God is the one killing people with sickness. In fact, do this. At least admit that God is bad.
But I'm sure you will not be talking about the father of Jesus Christ, because in the Bible, it is not recorded anywhere that God is responsible for those things. Is it not amazing that the one time he was asked, is it this person's sin? Is it the sin of their father? What did he say? It is so that God's glory will be seen. God is so much on the positive side of things. Yeah? That in the worst of things, he sees good. I want to show you something. I want to prove to you that you are not a Burji, you are not a Borana, you are not a Gabra. I want to show you that it is impossible to be a Luo and a Christian at the same time. It is impossible. You are either a Christian or you are a Burji. You are either a Christian or you are a Ndile. You choose one. You make a choice. You make a choice. You make a choice. You cannot be a Burji Christian. It is impossible. It is impossible. It will never work. Hawezi kuwa mukikuyu mukristo. Wewe ni mukristo ama wewe ni mukikuyu. You pick one. If God is good enough for you, you go with God and you forsake everything. If Kikuyu is good enough, stay there. Don't come over. I posted something on Facebook in the morning. I said, if you don't want prosperity, don't become a Christian. It is true. If you don't want peace, if you're not interested in life, don't be a Christian. Stay wherever you are. But if you come on this side, we live by the rules of this side. Praise the Lord. I'm saying hawezi kuwa mburji na mkristo. Hawezi. Mungu si mburji, Mungu si mkikuyu. Praise the Lord. It is impossible. It is a mathematical and spiritual impossibility to be in two places at once. The verse we read, can we go back there? 2 Corinthians. We praise God for the rain. Amen. Yeah. Look at verse 18. Does it say all things are of God? Does it say that? Does it say all things are of God? How many things? Some things are of Burji, some things are... How many things are of God? If any man beware in Christ. Does your Bible say that? Let us go to Galatians chapter 3 so that we summarize. Hallelujah. Galatians chapter 3. Hallelujah. When we say I'm what God says I am, this is a song for Christians. Yeah? People who have believed God. People who are in Christ. Can you say in Christ? In Christ. Yeah. If any man be in Christ, all things have passed away. All things have become new. And all things are of who? Of God. Say of God. All things are of God. Please say, all things are of God. All things are of God. Kila kitu ni ya Mungu. Kila kitu ni ya Mungu. Tamaduni zetu, lugha yetu, mafikira zetu, matumaini yetu, yote ni ya Mungu. Everything about us is of God. If any man be in Christ.
Let us go to Galatians chapter 3. And down there. Now, if you disagree with what I'm saying, you are wrong. Amen? You are wrong, because I am reading for you from the Bible, from the Word of God. And the things I am reading are true. Jesus said, I am the truth. I am the truth. I am the truth. There is no other truth. Inje ya hii, hakuna ukweli nyingine. The Bible is not a suggestion of God. Try this. If it doesn't work, go try something else. No. When the Bible declares something, the scriptures, the only reason why many Christians have not believed the word of God is because they have not considered it. Do you know what to consider is? Mtu akikuwa mgonjwa sana anaambiwa enda sijui nini ama kirwa. I know kirwa because I've had kirwa very much. Ama India. Now, for that person, there are things he's supposed to consider. Sindio? How much is his life worth? How much can he afford? How much is he willing to struggle, you see, to make sure he gets what he wants? Kuna consideration, sindio? Meaning you are between different opinions. Kuna opinion ya kuenda kirwa, na kuna opinion ya India, sindio? So he is considering, should I do this or should I do this? The reason why we have never accepted anything God says, I'm telling you, even in our own local settings, the reason why when God says something, it is not good enough, is because we have not considered inside. It is, you people are so gullible to the lies of the devil because they have not considered God's side of the story. Pastor said something here that shook me on the inside. He said the reason why, do you hear me? Mnanisikiza? Pastor said the reason why God has not had the privilege, sababu ambayo Mungu hajakuwa na nafasi ya kuonekana, ni kwa sababu maneno yake haitambuliki katika tamaduni zetu. Na nikisema tamaduni, sio lazima ikuwe ile ya kuvaa nguo ya kitamaduni. They're just normal conversations. The moment you mention Jesus, it gets weird. Do you think it's by chance? Is it by chance? Una mention tu jina ya Bwana atanisaidia, alafu watu wanaanza kukuona. Even the most talkative person, ule mtu anapenda kuongea sana, ukileta mambo ya imani yako, ananyamaza. Enter any room and complain about politics. Utaona ile response utapata. Ruto, sijui nini. Mention anything about Jesus. Useme, unajua Mungu hapendi hizi vitu. Hautapata maoni mingi. At least sio na hiyo excitement. Watasema tu, Mungu tu atuonyeshe mahali itani. Praise God. I want to assure you, as far as heaven is concerned, the word of God is the most powerful thing on the face of the earth. As far as God knows. Now that is whether human beings acknowledge it or not. God is not God subject to opinion of men. No. He made men. He existed before them. He is God, independent of any man. If the biggest preacher in the world renounced Jesus, Jesus will still be the highest name. Yeah. It makes no difference. He's not mighty because many people believed in him. No.
He was mighty before they believed in him.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
I want you to see something in the book of Galatians. We thank God for the rain. The Lord have mercy on Christine and Kevin. They have gone to minister in Sasura Girls, Ukochini. Galatians chapter 3. Let us read from verse 26. Galatians, wa Galatia, amani Galatia. Mlango wa tatu, mstari wa 26. Amen, amen. Praise God. Galatians chapter 3 verse 26 says, "For you are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus." Amen. For you are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. At that point, let us go back to 2 Corinthians 5:17 again. What did the other one say? For you are all the children of God through faith in Christ Jesus. You are all the children of God through faith in Christ Jesus. Nyinyi nyote ni watoto wa Mungu kupitia imani katika Kristo Yesu. Amen. I'm flowing in Kiswahili, Jesus. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17 tulisoma inasema, therefore if any man be in Christ, you are all the children of God through faith in Christ Jesus. Children of God. Here he says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Wherever you came from, whichever tribe, before you believed in him, kabla hujamuamini, ukuwe umetoka kwa kabila gani, the moment you enter Christ, old things are passed away. All things about you have become new, and everything about you is of God. Praise the Lord. Everything about you is of Amen, hallelujah. How many things about you are of God? Have you shared some things with your community and others with God? No, there is a community of God. Mantaye. Amen. There is a community of God. You don't bring your traditions to the people of God. No. Old things are passed away. Everything you had before, hizo vitu umeamini katika kabila yako na watu wako, hata ile umefunzwa na watu wako, old things are passed away. All things have become new. Your tradition is the word of God now. Your community is the community of the children of God. Yes, this is your community now. We are your community. You are loyal to God and to us. Yeah. It's true. It's very true. It's very true. There is no excommunication in this community. Amen. Yeah. Even if you don't vote for the same person as us, we will not remove you from our community. Yeah. Even if you do not do church wedding, we don't care. We want you to do church wedding. But if you don't do church wedding, as long as you want to be a part of us, we are waiting for you. But if you come to us, all things are passed away. All things are of God. You are not a Burji, a Rendile, a Gabra. No. Now a Gabra, a Pana, a Simbe. Bwana asifiwe. I am officially deleting that song from this pulpit in Jesus' name. We will not sing that song again. Amen. Yeah.
Sisi ni watoto wa Mungu.
Yeah. We have a lot of confusion because we are mixing things. We are mixing things. We want to pick some good things from Burji. We don't need anything from them. Let them stay with their. We have moved. Amen. We have moved from there. We are in another place. Amen. It is called the church of God. It is called the pillar of truth, the ground of truth. Read, it is in the book of Timothy. This is the mother of truth. Amen. Yeah. Listen, it is good enough. Wherever on earth you find yourself, you will find people like us. We are everywhere. We are not in a corner fighting over a piece of land. No. We are everywhere. The whole earth belongs to our master. Yeah. Anywhere we set our foot belongs to us. We don't need to fight over a corner. No. Praise the Lord. Bwana asifiwe. If any man be where? In Christ. Bible inasema put off the old man. Sindio? It's somewhere. It is in Colossians. Yeah? It says put off the old man and his deeds. Put him off. Remove him. Unajua ku put off. Nikitoa hii shati nimetoa. It is there, I'm here. It says put off your former selves, your former manner of life. It says put it aside. The reason why most people want to find good in their tribe is they have not taken time to find good in the word of God. Wanatafuta mema kwa kabila yao kwa sababu hawajakuwa na nafasi ya kuona nini. Amen, amen, hallelujah. Yeah. Yeah. God is making a statement. Amen. Saying I'm the Lord of this land. Yeah. I can reign when I want. Amen. Yeah, we thank him. We thank him. We belong to him. Amen. Yeah, we are his people. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Can we just pray in Jesus' name? Stand up, walk around and pray. Manta Yazarita. Leshtra Ezanda Lotoyozo. Bozangri Natila Zinan Shayita Zeba. Thank you, Jesus. Manka Yospa. Onta Robona Lodanste. Mezingra Lojati Yiti Zeba. Beketa yeba zanda rashtu lonta ozaginde lezibra mayuta lindezipa takima zimba rotolo oyazonde neshtre eyezenanga bianti sitela yigrozinanshe. Thank you for the rain. Thank you for the rain. You have opened up the heavens. We thank you, our Father. Makarokoto, Lord Azontemo, Boyandra Zitapa, Mijandi Lundare, Kama Zata Yampala. Thank you, Jesus. Father, thank you for the rain. Lambro Ayagandes, thank you. You have blessed us. This rain is a blessing to this land. Our farms will produce in the name of Jesus. Our livestock will be fed. In the name of Jesus, this rain is a rain of blessing. In Jesus' name, the Lord has blessed us with rain. Manka oyazo, rontana oyazo nante letepa, Mizangri natila jinante. Yete seka egarantona. Lobro za ginta yinda sila. Ijandri la gunta yimpasile. Mesekete yenta lesdo. O jandri na sukata yampazima. Thank you, Jesus. Father, thank you. You are good. You are good. We thank you for your goodness. Thank you. You have transformed our lives. You have blessed us in every way. Mante ezare. Le proja ginta yinda sitila. Sintona oyagozande rentemu. Montazopos lokropae. Zedigalinta yindiziro. Librozansha ayanki sitela. Thank you, Jesus. You'll be lifted. You'll be worshipped and be praised. Thank you for this blessing. Lord, we thank you from every corner of this land. Receive all the praise. Receive all the praise that it is said that God gave us rain. God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, blessed us with rain. Manka yozena rente jekata iba sinta lindarizo yigranta zunda litisida manta yagabruto lonko yosbo oyagondash. We give you all the praise. We worship your excellent name. Your name is the most amazing name, the most excellent and wonderful name, the name of Jesus. The name that people call on when there is nobody to call. The name that is standby at all times. Ranta Ajade. You are our very present help in times of need. You are a friend that sticks closer than a brother. Father, we have found you. We love you. We praise your name. You have called us out of darkness and brought us into your amazing light. We give you all the praise. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for your embrace. Thank you for your ministry, even in this place. Thank you for the miracle that you're working in the lives of your people. Wewe ni Mungu, hakuna wakufananishwa na wewe, umeinuliwa kushinda miungu yote. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. Shall we be seated? Today we are having a very strange kind of fellowship, but it is good. We are sit- God is not religious. Amen? Yeah, sometimes he switches up things. So it's time to pray. So trying to raise his voice. God says, it's time to pray. Amen? Yeah, we thank God. Other gods are terrorizing people, killing others. Yeah, our God is giving us rain. Yeah, yeah. He's the one blessing us. Yeah. Other, the gods of religious people is angry because of sin. That is not the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Father of the Lord Jesus Christ is this. He's having a good time. Bwana asifiwe. Yeah. So we pray that he continues reigning in Jesus' name. Yeah, that it will be a wonderful reign. So I want, let me finish that Galatians 3 from verse 26 where I was reading. I want to show you this where he says, as many, verse, let us look at verse 27 now. Galatians 3:27. Inasema, as many of you as have been baptized into Christ, have put on Christ. You have been baptized into him. You have put him on, he says. Now, in verse 28, he says, there is neither Jew nor Greek, neither bond nor free. I've heard people say, ata Yesu alitimiza ahadi ya ni tamaduni ya Wayahudi. Kile hawajui ni Wayahudi sio community kama hizi zingine. Wayahudi ni watoto wa Abraham. Abraham alitolewa kutoka nyumba ya baba yake, tamaduni yake, akawekwa kando. Hakuambiwa aende na tamaduni zake. Tamaduni ya Wanaisraeli, the Ten Commandments, even if they produced more commandments, the Ten Commandments are from the God of heaven. These are, it is not normal tradition. God has never borrowed anything from the devil. It has never happened. So hata wakisema, hata Yesu alitimiza tamaduni. Tamaduni Yesu alitimiza ni tamaduni ya Mungu, the Ten Commandments. He lived by them perfectly. Yeah, Yesu hakutimiza tamaduni ya wagabra, no. Now, let me finish this part. He says, there is neither Jew nor Greek. Even that one now, he says, that it is not there now. Amen? Now it says here, it has been put aside. There is neither male nor female. When we say we are sons of God, our sisters should also say we are sons of God. In the spirit you are sons. All of us are sons. Amen? Yeah. And then he says, if you be Christ, then you are Abraham's seeds and heirs according to the promise. Do you know what that promise is? In blessing, I will bless you. In multiplying, I will multiply you. If somebody tries to curse you, they are cursed. If they bless you, they are blessed. You are untouchable. This is a very closed community. Yes. We have code of conduct. We are not lawless people. We have the law of God, except it is not the law cast on stones. It is in our hearts. It is in our system to live for God. We are wired to live for God. Inside us right now, there is no imperfection like this. Regardless of what you did during lunchtime. Hata kama ulifanya dhambi gani during lunchtime. Hata kama utafanya dhambi gani kesho. Hii si kitu ulipatiwa na mpaka ukose. Unajua kuna Wakristo wanaamini ile dhambi Yesu ametusamee ni mpaka tumeamini yeye. Kuanzia hapo kwenda mbele nabebana na habana. It is not in the Bible, that is people's own creation. I want to tell you something. The reason why we are stuck in our own traditions, these are basics of Christianity. Hizi tungefunzwa Sunday school. The reason why watu wamekataa kwa matamu. Unajua hata hii kwani ni mbaya. Ungeona ya Mungu haungekuwa una debate hapa. So they are standing here, they tell you kwani kuna makosa gani? Tunafanyanga hivi tu alafu tunafanyanga hivi. Mbona usikuje hapa uone venye tunafanyanga? Why aren't you interested in what God is saying? Unajua kama mtu ameona neno la Mungu na ameona Mungu, hana tamaa ya kuenda kwa shetani hata siku moja, hata kumtembelea. Bwana asifiwe. Nilisikia jamaa akisema, "Hello poverty, this is your former friend. I want to tell you we will never come back again. It's over between us." I heard such a thing in some of these social media places. Says, "Hello poverty, this is your former customer. I want to tell you it is over between us." That is what you do. You cut off link with the devil completely, because in fact, in the heart of everyone mwenye anakuja hapa, I'm very sure, I've not been inside your hearts, but I know you are interested in knowing more of the word of God. Is that true? Yes, obviously, because you want to know how to live. This is the path to life. Bwana asifiwe. Unataka kujua Mkristo anafaa kuishi aje. Bwana asifiwe. Unataka kuomba sana. Unataka kujifunza ni vipi mtu anaomba sana. You are interested. That is not you. It is the spirit that God put inside you that is bubbling inside you. He wants to pray. He wants to be around his Father. Yeah. It's who you are now. You don't have to struggle. Bwana asifiwe. That's why Pasi anasemanga usingoje hadi ukue mzuri sana uanze kukuja kanisa. Kama wewe ni mzuri hata mbona unahitaji kanisa? You come here so that you are taught how to live. And some of us tumekuwa hapa hata hatujui vitu zingine zilitutoka aje. Some problems hata hatukuwa tunajua tuko nayo. Imetoka tu unatafuta unakosa. Like my sister said, she looked and it was normal. That is the formula. God wants to help us naturally. Bwana asifiwe. Naturally. But we have these Christians who want to pray, we want to fast, and then tunataka kutoa pesa ya kabila. The moment you turn to your tribe, you have neutralized things. Bwana asifiwe. Renounce your tribe today. Bwana asifiwe. I'm not saying borrow some good things. I'm saying renounce your tribe today. You have a new tribe. It's the tribe of life. Yeah. We are the children of God. God said, you are the light of the world. Your tribe wants to conquer a region. God wants you to bring nations to Him. Uliona hapa anasema,
He has blessed us. He has reconciled us to God, and then he has made us ministers of reconciliation.
Alituunganisha na Mungu, akatufanya watu ambao wanaenda kuunganisha watu na Mungu. Mali tunaenda yote tunaenda kutafuta kujeni kuna.
You see those guys who come here and they want help. These are people whose hearts know they belong someplace. Bwana asifiwe.
And their hearts are yearning to find salvation. When they meet you and they are drawn to that life, they are changed. Everybody here was brought by somebody.
Bwana asifiwe.
And whoever worked through that somebody is God.
Bwana asifiwe.
He's gathering his people and aleta watu wake pamoja.
Yeah?
You can stop being, don't even talk about your tribe. Forget about your tribe. You are a Christian.
Sisi ni waborana. Hata kama nini? Tamaduni yetu, kama ni tamaduni yenu, you don't belong in this house. You are living a lie. You cannot be a double agent.
Bwana asifiwe.
Yeah. You cannot put your one leg here and then one leg here. Utaenda wapi? Where will you go? You are not progressing as a Christian. You are not becoming the kingpin of your tribe. Where are you? Yeah. If you want to be the legend of your village, stay in your tribe. If you want to join the chariots of life, come on this side. Fully come.
Bwana asifiwe.
Fully come. Usingie mambo hata ya manyata. I know it sounds extreme, but it is. It really is. It is that simple. God is light. In him there is no darkness at all. You are the light of the world. You are a city I have put on top of a hill. It is impossible to hide you.
That is what the Bible says. Matthew 5:14.
You are a city on top of a hill.
You want to hide under the table of your...
No. No, we are not loyal to anybody. We are loyal to the Lord. Bwana asifiwe. We are made to be loyal to him. We are inside him.
Ben Isaac alisema, you have disappeared into one another with God. Yeah? Do you know what disappearing into one another is? Kuingiana kabisa. If it's blue, we are blue. Bwana asifiwe. We have lost each other and each other. Bwana asifiwe. Yeah, we are not standing in two places. I know our parents want us to be included in the community. It's because they have been deceived themselves. It's true. It's true they are deceived. They think some people are unclean and others are clean. The same devil is telling some people he's dirtier than you and he's in both of you. There is no human being that is better than the other human being. You believe, you become saved, you become a child of God. You are
as legitimate, you are as clean to God as somebody who has been a pastor for 60 years. Makes no difference. As soon as you believe, you are in darkness and then you turn to light. You are not better because of the tribe, the side of the tribe you come from. Unajua hata kwa kabila kuna wale wametoka kwa hii region na hii region. Sijui tribe zingine. Hii tribe yetu iko na isi tribe yetu, isi tribe tulitoka. Bwana asifiwe. Iko na hii tabia. Kuna wale wa hii side na wale wa hii side. Wa hii side ni wazuri kushinda wa hii side. Hata kwa hii side na I'm sure hakuwezi kosa wa hii side na hiyo side ingine. It does not end. The same devil anacheza ping pong na kila mtu. Anaambia mtu moja, huyu ni unclean, huyu ni more clean. Kwa sababu gani? Babu yake alikuwa anakaa chini ya miti, alikuwa anaishi huko. Kuna upuzi kama hiyo. Ya? Yeah? Musioe kutoka hiyo side. Kwa nini? Watu wao wanakula nguruwe.
A lot of nonsense. A lot of nonsense.
Alafu ignorant Christians wanasema, hata kwa sheria ya Musa imesemekana. Wewe ni umekufu. Ni Musa alikukufia ama ni Yesu alikukufia. Ya? Yeah? Hata ungejua sheria ya Musa, ungejua hiyo maneno iliisha.
Ignorance, a lot of ignorance. We are sitting with them, making stories with them. They are too wangi hiyo side.
Kwa nini amuoi?
Unajua, hata kama sisi ni Christians, hata kama
You know, if you talk like that, there is nothing you know.
Yes,
sisi ni Wakristo, yes, but the moment umesema, but you are gone. Bwana asifiwe. Pick a side. Amen. Yeah. Elijah, is it Elijah who told people, if God is God, serve him. If Baal is God, go serve him. Says, how long will you be torn between two opinions? Ni mara muda gani muta? Kama Baal ni Mungu, fuateni yeye. Mulato was asking me. Ah, Mungu, wenye wanakanga hivi pamoja, ah, hizi makabila kabila, like especially now the two tribes that are fighting now. Yeah? That have been fighting and have been stopped in the name of Jesus. We need to re-edit our conversation continually until we speak right. They are praying. This one is praying. Eh? Mungu tupatia amani. And then the other one is praying. Mungu tupatia amani. Is this God not telling them to love other people? That other people are God's creation too. Which God is that? No, if that is God, which God is that? Yeah? We have people who call themselves men of God going to bow for that demon. Those, nini? And then they are trying to tell us that we are all praying to the same God. Ignorant Christians are saying, no. No, we have no association with darkness. Light has no fellowship with darkness. I know this is hard saying, but if you know what I'm talking about right now, it is not hard saying. It is simple truth. Unajua ukweli ikichanganywa na vitu ndio inaanza kuwa complicated. Watu wawili wakikosana, ukikalisha moja hapa na ukalisha mwingine hapa, wakiongea ukweli hiyo maneno utatatua in 2 minutes. Wakianza kusema lakini unajua hata yeye angesema, angefanya. When you start going round na issues, utakaa hapa 2 hours. But if you know the truth, it is very simple. Nasikia pastor alienda kwa nyumba, one of the people here were fighting. They had an argument. They were arguing. I hear they went there for a whole week. Every jioni ni kama discipleship tu. Walienda kila jioni. Unajua ilifika mahali, pastor alipatiwa nafasi ya kuongea once. Pastor said, just forgive each other. There is no benefit in strife. Forgive each other. The Bible says to forgive each other. You are Christians, forgive each other. Let go of anything. Like that, yo maneno iliisha. The whole week, they were debating. Pastor hakuchukua 2 minutes. You see? Light. Do not allow yourself. Listen, I know some of you think that this is one of the opinions. This is not. This is the holy word of God. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away.
Everything is up. God is not in the business of trying to make one tribe more popular than the other. One has secret. God is not behind the ideology of the politics of this country. God is not interested in Buddhist Christians, in Borana Christians, in Rendita Christians. God is interested in those that have believed in His Son. He gave His best.
Good and is hiding behind the mask. Bwana asifiwe. What the devil needs is somebody like one woman said, somebody who will pull the curtain like this and tell him, I see you. I see. Ameweka curtain. Yeah. Eh? Muvae tu for safety. For your safety. Eh? Vaeni mask. Mheshimu serikali. Mudungwe shindano haina shida, ni kama polio tu. Ni kama polio tu. Mudungi tu haina shida. Sasa kuna haja kweli ukose kazi? Dunga tu. Watu ambao hawana dakika moja kukaa ndani ya neno la Mungu. They are trying to tell us how to live. Who is the devil to advise me? Somebody said, if you don't listen to Jesus, why should I listen to you? What better do you have to tell me that Jesus does not tell me? Is there a secret that a minister knows that Jesus does not know? No. Can I ask you a very simple question? If all of the decisions, let alone the devil, sawa, wachana na shetani, ile uamuzi umejifanya katika maisha yako mpaka saizi, ungesikia Mungu, ni how many better choices ungefanya sai? Do you realize even you are a danger to yourself if you are left alone? Forget about even the tribe. Forget about the country. Wewe peke yako, ukiwachwa peke yako, utajimaliza. Yeah. I am telling you, you are not safe alone. Forget about your tribe. The only option we have is Jesus. There is no option. Do you know what Paul said? None of these things move me. Alifanyiwa kila kitu. Akasema, hizi zote. Anasema, my only goal is to finish my course with joy. He says, I want to finish my time on earth in joy. He says, as long as Jesus is what I have. Hey, this is dangerous. This is dangerous. He said, do you know what dung is? Dung. Kosi, you know your kosi? Kosi kwa Kiswahili ni nini? Waste. He says, I count everything as waste. Unaona mavi ya mbuzi. Everything. Ndiyo apate nani? Yesu. Na watu wanataka Yesu na kabila yao. You are joking, God. You are not serious. Don't argue with people who don't know these things. Amen? Don't argue with them. Tell them, may God help you and let them be. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Yeah, don't waste your time. Some people, you can be standing on your feet. Like I was telling my brother Abraham once, unless the Holy Spirit turns on the light from the inside of people, they will not accept these things. It is revelation knowledge. It is the Holy Spirit. When Peter was talking, this is a beautiful interruption. Amen. When Peter told Jesus, you are Christ, the Son of God. When Peter told Jesus, you are Christ, the Son of God. When he said that, he thought he was speaking his mind. But he was speaking the mind of God. God was using him and he did not know it. I'm sure he felt very nice. Yeah? Flesh and blood did not reveal that to you, but my Father who is in heaven. I'm sure Peter felt like, God revealed it to you. This simple thing you believe. Unajua wewe unaona ni simple. But like mom taught in the morning, this is a mystery revealed to you. It is only to you. Now, if somebody will receive it, if somebody is humble enough
Unajua mtu akinyenyekea akubali ajui, Mungu atamsaidia ajue. Usilazimishe watu, usiseme wewe si Mkikuyu, wachana na yeye, sawa? Akijua ukweli, akikuja katika imani, akikuuliza utamfunza. Lakini usiende kulazimisha watu, sawa? Sende kugonga watu, sema ugonjwa ni ya shetani. Bwana asifiwe. Yeah, God will reveal it to them as they come to him. Amen. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Thank you for this ministry. Thank you for what you're doing through this ministry in this land. Our lives are transformed. We thank you. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. You are changing our perception of everything. You are washing our perception by the water of the word. You are cleaning us from every filth of sin. You are putting us aside for your glory. You are exalting your name in our lives. We want to thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Father, thank you. Receive all the glory, receive all the praise. These things we pray, believing and trusting in the name of Jesus. Amen. And now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit.